and welcome to the 2020 Sugarcane Field Day. This is the variety talk portion. My name is Michael Pontiff. I've been an assistant breeder out here for over 13 years, and I'm excited today to talk about the release of a new variety, which is always an exciting thing. A couple of months ago, we went over the data of 12 years, over 250 observations of HO 13739, and it was voted unanimously to be released to the sugarcane industry. So I'll start off talking about the new variety and what to look for in it. So the first thing I want to tell you about this HO 13739 is one of the parents, the male parent, is 838. And if you're familiar with 838, you know a parent of 838 is 384. So 384, after all these years, is still in that tree and still producing new varieties through parental lineage. So HO 13739, the one thing that stands out about the variety right off the top is early sugar. It's one of the earliest sugars we've seen come through the program in a while. It's along with 283 early sugar numbers. That's a marked characteristics of this variety. Another thing about HO 13739 is good tonnage. It's got good tonnage, good sugar per acre. The disease package on HO 13739, it's going to be moderately susceptible to the sugarcane borer. Being as sweet as it is, that's not uncommon, like 950, very susceptible to the sugarcane borer. And it's going to be moderately susceptible to brown rust. Being that 384 is a grandparent, 384 was taken down by rust, that's not uncommon. It's resistant to both smut and leaf scald. This past year, during the fall, we had the freeze on November 13th of last year, and we had an outfield test up in Cheneyville, Louisiana, where we turned into a freeze test, a cold tolerance test. And HO 13739 was one of those varieties in that test. So it was harvested five times in the month of after November and into December to determine its cold tolerance. And it came out as pretty cold tolerant, as opposed to the previous year's releases of 615 and 201, which are poor as far as cold tolerance goes. 739 falls more along the lines of 838 and 540 as being a little more cold tolerant. So you wouldn't have to rush out there to get it if we had a freeze like we had last year early on November 13th. Another thing about 13739, as you'll see, it's a pretty big stalk. If you can see here, dark green color. It holds about a 2 pound weight throughout its life cycle, dropping below that in third stubble. As always, when we have these field days, we hand out the characteristic sheets and on one side and the data on the other side, which you can find on the Ag Center website and download and look at the numbers for yourself. But if you look at the numbers of 739 along with the other varieties on this sheet, you'll see that 739 was statistically better, significantly better than 299 in many categories, especially sugar content. And on that sheet, you'll see plant cane through third stubble. And you'll see the outfield portion is the last 4 years of the 12-year program. And 739 performed well in that, well enough to be released, obviously. And you can see the plant cane data through third stubble, and you can see 739 in plant cane and first stubble, and it's going to be in second stubble this year in the outfield. Along with the what's coming down the line for the future years, we have two 14 series, 14267, an L variety, and an HO variety, 14885. Both of those are in the outfield, the latter stages of the program. They both look good. They will be up for release next year, and next April, May. Those could also be coming. And if you look on that sheet and you look at the numbers, you'll see there's three 15 series that are going to be up in 2 years from now. So there's several varieties coming through the pipeline to go with the established varieties we have. And on that sheet, if you see the characteristics, we now have 10 varieties on that sheet, starting with 540, all the way through the last releases of 12, 201, and 615 last year, and now 739. And as we tell farmers all the time, the seed availability, you contact the league and for seed availability of 739. We always say if you can get some seed of that, get you some seed and try it on your farm to see how well it perform on your farm. A lot of questions I get is how does this variety do on light soil as compared to heavy soil? We always get that with a new variety. And throughout the program, this one did equally good on both heavy and light soil. As it's added acreage in the industry, we'll see, you know, some more numbers because we'll continue to test it in our outfield portion of the program. And if there's any questions or comments or anything you need to know about the variety, you can contact me through email or call the Sugar Research Station. We'll be happy to talk about this new variety, or go on the website and download the sheet so you can read about the outfield data and this new variety, HO 13739. Thank you.